Is Stencyl easy to use?
Stencyl is one of those game development engines intended for those who cannot code. In that regard, it is a lot easier than learning to program.
So is GameSalad. I want to know which not-for-programmers tool to use to create games.
One of the benefits of Stencyl is its large number of behaviors or gameplay routines. You do not have to define nearly as many rules as, say, GameSalad.
That's Stencyl Forge.
That's where the existing behaviors can be downloaded from, yes. You can customize the behaviors too. Like a rule requiring an object to follow a path or follow the target, and the spacing or time intervals.
Those define the rules for the graphics you put in for the virtual world. How hard is it to create the virtual world itself?
It uses a drag-and-drop interface to create the virtual world, like GameSalad.
So it is kind of like GameSalad.
It does not require nearly as many rules to run a similarly complex game as GameSalad. And if you really want to, you can hand-code routines on your own, in the Haxe programming language.
That sounds like Haxe as in Haxer.
It is supposed to be pronounced like Haxe, like magic.
Or curses.
Another great thing about Stencyl is all the tools that connect with the game. For example, you can use Easy RPG Creator with Stencyl 3.0.
I'm assuming Easy RPG stands for Easy Role Playing Game.
Yes. Dialogue Extension is a dialogue tool used with Stencyl. That's a pretty easy tool to use.
So why don't I hear a lot that's good about Stencyl?
It is enough to make simple 2D games, but you cannot make 3D games. The physics and collisions modeling is poor at best.
That's a common issue with any other free game dev tools.
The user interface for versions 1.0 and 2.0 were lousy. The interface and logic dramatically improved with version 3.0. It also simplified the process of importing images from other tools like Photoshop, and exporting games to Adobe Flash.
I've heard enough people complain about Adobe Flash failing on mobile devices, to see why that's a negative for a game engine that relies on it.
You can export games as executable files or iOS and Android applications too.
Being able to make a whack-a-mole game of my least favorite person, and posting it to all the mobile app platforms, is certainly a plus.